I believe that the EDSA revolution, the first one, proved that the Philippines, as a people, is capable of uniting against an idealistic goal, which is to destroy a corrupt dictatorship and to put up a true and just democracy. But unfortunately, I believe the Philippines is a one-time, big-time kind of thing.
I honestly think that the Filipino people haven't really learned any kinds of lessons from EDSA 1. Because the fact remains that while EDSA 1 was a people power movement, it wasn't any actual revolution. The kind of change that we really need is different from what happened in EDSA. EDSA was more of symbolic than an actual change.
Welcome back. Our question, have PMA graduates lived up to the values of courage, integrity, and loyalty? And is the spirit of EDSA still alive? I wanted to ask you, one of the questions, yung Tagalog na napakahaba, iniinom mo, sinabi mo concisely, ang tinatanong lang niya, nasayang ba yung 25 years?
No, not at all.
Nasayang ba yung 25 years?
Hindi po, Ma'am Tinay. I'd like to tell our viewers out there, na hindi po nasayang. We have to take the entire period in segments. Mm-hmm. Remember that the first 5 years after 1986 was a period of confusion, of trauma, of coups. Mm-hmm. And then the next period was a period of when General Ramos became president. We transitioned into a period of resolution and upgrade of capabilities. And then after him, 9/11 and Camp Abu Bakar and Bali bombings hit us. We weren't prepared for that. So we had to have internal resolution. And then after that, when President Macapagal Arroyo came into power, we had to slowly professionalize and look at the basics, at our resources. So all throughout the period, it's not a linear growth, by the way, gave us opportunities to learn and relearn some basics. And every step of the way, we were developing along a curve.
And did we learn?
Yes.
What is the valuable lesson to you?
The valuable lesson to us is we need to increasingly rely on ourselves instead of depending on outside help. We need to get closer to the Filipino people. We need to know their language, their needs.
Mm-hmm. Yes. And Colonel Gapay, is there a lesson of EDSA that is...
On the part of the military organization.
No, for you individually first, before the military. What is the lesson for you as a soldier and an officer?
Yes, the environment we are in is very dynamic, and really have to undergo reform once in a while. Mm-hmm. It's a continuing thing, actually, from reform to transformation, for the betterment of for ourselves, or as a human being, as a person, and for the organization also. Mm-hmm. And on the part of the armed forces, in fairness to our organization, if you compare the armed forces during the martial law years, talagang tinyente kami ng kagagraduate namin, ramdam namin yung stigma ng martial law, particularly sa remote communities, pag talaga takot na takot yung tao pag nagpapatrol kami. If we patrol the hinterlands of our country,
takot sa inyo?
Takot yung mga tao.
Because tinatakot ninyo?
No.
The stigma. Just the stigma.
That's lang? A uniform. Yeah. And lalapitan namin, kaya SOP, may candy kami. The children, iba na. That's why after the revolution, the AP was called the new AFP. Mm-hmm. Kaya that's why painstakingly, that's what we're telling the people na we are the new AFP. Iba na yung panahon ng martial law, wala na yan. Yung mga barangay officials sabi, sir, sosunahin niyo ba yung barangay namin? No, we're here to work with you for peace and development. That's what we're telling them. Mm-hmm. And really, over time, even right now, meron pa nga eh. Mm-hmm. Talaga sa remote areas. Pero gradually, over time, nawawala na rin. Mm-hmm. And I'd just like to say that the AP now is totally different from the AP we had during the martial years. For example, sa promotion system lang namin, hindi na yung point system kagaya ng araw, ikaw, promoted na kayo, generals na kayo. Point. Ngayon, it's purely meritocracy, really. You have to earn your rank, you have to be qualified for a certain position. So, it's very professional. In resource management, nung tenyente kami, wala kaming support. I mean, what we call maintenance and operating expenses. As a platoon leader, I never received any support. We're just working on our own. That's why, and right now, iba na, there's a standard support for you, the even the lowest unit.
Sa PNP, ano yung, is there something in the PNP, PNP's mandate that actually reflects whatever EDSA was or EDSA is now in your own life as a police officer?
Yeah, it's a change, a revolution. And because the PNP has a different story. Because of the 1987 Constitution, there was a mandate there to change the entire force into a one police force, national in scope, civilian in nature. And of course, there was also a stigma because the PC then was to implement and regulate laws. So when the PNP law came about, it was quite a difficult adjustment on our part. And even for myself, as a career advancement, I took up law. And you know, it's really difficult to explain to the soldier because the soldiers before, they were saying that the prosecutors are not on their side because during cross-examination, the prosecutors would grill them. And only when you study law that you can properly explain these things to the policemen that, you know, it's an entirely new system. We want a democracy. We want to celebrate EDSA. So let's take the pains of democracy and abide by it.
The naval officers of your class, of your batch, how are they taking the problems of the armed forces at this time, given the hearings at the Senate?
I have not discussed this. We have not discussed this thing very thoroughly as far as
Are you affected, happening? Having come from the armed forces and now watching this unfold in the comfort of our living rooms?
Well, I believe the common sentiment is that una-una wala naman nagde-deny about certain wrongdoings of certain individuals, but we would have wanted it to have been taken up in a different forum. In the first place, the case was already filed in the courts, and we'd have wanted that the case was pursued in the courts rather than in a forum that we have.
Because some more comments, yes. You wanted.
De, gusto ko lang balikan yung sa EDSA na tanong natin. Yeah. Individually, ang tingin ko dyan is, ito hindi revolusyon ng tao, hindi revolusyon ng mga sundalo, kundi revolusyon ng buong sambayanan na Pilipino. No? That naipakita natin na pag tayo ay nagsama-sama, magsasama-sama, meron tayong pwedeng gawin na isang magandang bagay na sa mapayapang paraan. And wanting to change for the better is not a job for Superman, for one person. It's a job for all of us Filipinos. And I believe we have that ability. Pinakita natin yan sa EDSA. And we can still do it, I believe. Kaya hindi sayang EDSA.
Some more comments before we go from Janice Yako. To live with integrity, loyalty, and courage is instilled in all the cadets and graduates of PMA. But each individual is given free will to live with integrity, courage, and loyalty. Therefore, it's their choice. But I still believe that if ever there are scandals in AFP nowadays, there are still a lot of PMA graduates out in the jungle and fighting for our country.
Bravo.
I know this is because my husband is also a PMAer. They serve our nation selflessly. They're living heroes. I just pray that the Filipino people will not condemn the whole institution of PMA and the AFP. And Hill of Santa Rosa, their integrity, loyalty, and courage seem to be for something else other than the country.